Students, after the previous lecture, now we come the variation of pressure vertically with depth. Pressure exerted by liquid column. In your book, you can see pressure exerted by a liquid column, but you can read it like this also. Variation of pressure vertically, when we are going to the depth, vertically we are going down, how the pressure changing takes place. And that we will learn here. And before that, you can see the ideal fluid. What is ideal fluid? A little bit concept that will need in senior class, but you can write it. Okay, what is the idea condition for ideal fluid? Okay, so pause the video, write it. Okay, now coming to here, pressure exerted by a liquid column. I think you can just pause the video and write the whole note. Okay, now come here. Pressure exerted by a liquid column. See, this is a liquid column. You can see it already it has drawn. Okay, liquid column. We just put it inside the liquid. Okay, inside the liquid we just put it, that liquid column. So what happened, you know that when just in this beaker there is some already liquid present with density rho, already some liquid present. When we put another liquid column, already this liquid will put some pressure on it, you know that. So the pressure it will feel in this point we will count. Okay, we will just calculate the pressure over this PQ surface. So let's come. So this is a cylinder. You can see PQRS, a cylinder is just immersed in a beaker contain a liquid density rho. Okay, and the height of the cylinder is h. We will calculate the pressure at PQ, and we just let the surface area is A. Okay, PQ surface, this surface area is A. So students, so liquid content cylinder PQRS, thrust exerted by the liquid at the surface PQ. See here, how much force will apply it? See, if we draw it downward like this, so here its mass is acting downwards, and a pressure P into a force, means force thrust, what you can thrust it, acting on it to push it upward, that is force is equal to P into a. As P is equal to F by a, so F is equal to P into a. F means thrust, not force, thrust. Be it attentive, listen it carefully. F means thrust. Okay, so A is equal to P A, so thrust acting on it is equal to P into A, and its mass means weight is pulling it down. So listen, thrust exerted on the liquid surface is equal to weight of the cylinder. Okay, so weight of the cylinder means volume into density into G. How it will come? It will come through the formula D is equal to M by V. You know that density is equal to mass by volume. So mass is equal to density into volume. Mass is equal to weight means mass into gravitational force G. So mass means volume into density here. Mass means volume into density. I hope clear. So volume into density into G, mass into gravitational force. So weight of the cylinder is volume into density into gravitational force of acceleration. Okay, now again, you know that volume is equal to area into height. Why? Volume is equal to length into breadth into height. Length into breadth is called area. So area into height, we can write volume as area into height. Density rho g. Okay, so a h rho g is the thrust exerted by the liquid, by this liquid, on this surface. Okay, thrust exerted by liquid on this surface. Okay, that is A H rho G. So what will be the pressure? Pressure means thrust by area. So thrust value is A H rho G. Pressure will be thrust by area, A H rho G by A. As this area is A, so same above it will be A H rho G. Again below will be A will cut away. So we will get P is equal to H rho G. So this is the pressure due to liquid column of height h. So this is the pressure due to liquid column of height h. Here is the pressure filled by the PQ surface is HG. Okay, and student total pressure at PQ. Total pressure it will be atmospheric pressure plus HG. So where the atmospheric pressure will come? Little bit confused. See, atmospheric pressure means above here, at the above, there will be a normal P naught. P naught is the atmospheric pressure. Here up to this liquid, above entire all the sides, there is the atmosphere is there. So they are putting a pressure on it, on this liquid. So that is P0, and this is the extra pressure due to its height. Okay, this extra pressure is HG. So we add P0 plus HG, that both is the total pressure. This both is the total pressure at the height, this point. Okay, at the surface PQ, total pressure filled by the surface PQ is P0 plus HG. So I hope students, you have understand the total pressure exerted by a liquid column at a special point below that column. Now come factor affecting pressure at a point in a liquid. What should be the factor affecting pressure at a point in a liquid? As we have formulated the equation, we have established that equation, you know that at any point that will be depend on this formula, P is equal to H rho G. As G is to constant and rho, density of a particular liquid also constant, so it will mainly depend on the height. Means height means depth. H means you will say depth, no height will be there. Okay, height means here, H means depth. So depth of the point below the free surface. Okay, so if that is the liquid surface, this is the free surface, so this is the depth of the cylinder. H means depth of the cylinder, depend on the depth of the point below the, so more depth, more pressure. Okay, you know that below this portion pressure is more rather than that this upper portion, and density of the liquid, if density will more, pressure will more, and acceleration due to gravity. So from this equation, very easily you can see that the factor affecting the pressure any point in the liquid, inside the liquid, depth, density, and acceleration. Okay, so from here you see as G used to constant, generally G used to constant. Okay, so because acceleration due to gravity used to the constant value for earth, hence it will just specially depend on height and density. So what we have seen, pressure only depend on height and density, but it's not depend on the shape, size of the vessel. Whatever the size of the vessel, but it will not depend on the size of the vessel, but only depth and the density. And also it is independent area of the surface area. So these two examples, we will draw a picture over here that you can easily understand. Students, watch it. There is the different vessel. There is a different vessel A, B, C, D. See, same liquid. Height is same and same liquid we have taken. Same liquid means rho, density also same. Height means depth is same. Same height liquid we have taken. Okay, A up to this, B up to this, C up to this, and D. See, every liquid's height is same. And as we have taken same liquid, so their density also same. So what will be the pressure at the point A, B, C, D? See, PA, P, suppose I am just accepting them as PA, PB, PC, PD. Okay, so what will be their values? Their all value will be equal. See, PA is equal to PB, PC, because as height is equal and density is equal, we know that P is equal to H rho G, height equal, density equal, and G used to constant. So everywhere this point pressure will be same. Whether this container is bigger or lesser, it will not depend on the size and shape of this container. Similarly for B, see the surface area. Here surface area more, here surface area less, but its weight, it gives the pressure over here, and here all are same. It will not depend on the surface area also. I think you have understand, it will not depend on the size of the container as well as the surface area. Now come to the next topic, variation of pressure horizontally. See student, that we have learned vertically. Vertically we have pushed, that is vertical. Okay, vertical. Now we will come horizontal, this horizontal. So horizontally, how the pressure variate? Okay, for a static fluid, non-accelerated, I told you that we will learn only static fluid in your chapter, in your syllabus, only static fluid is given. That's why we are learning only static fluid. See, similarly, just like what the column experiment we have done, similar experiment we will take a column here. Vertically we have taken, horizontally we have taken. Okay, here we have taken it vertically, what I have explained already. Here we will take it horizontally. Horizontally, suppose this portion pressure is P1, here P2. So pressure means force, it will act, F is equal to P into A. Force means this side will be P1A and this side will be P2A, and their weight is H weight vertically downwards, acts vertically downwards. Vertically means we will not consider, we will consider only horizontal. So weight is working vertically, we will not consider weight. Hence there is nothing, no other factor is there. Okay, no other factor is there. Hence the horizontally we consider force from both sides. P1A is equal to P2A, means P1 is equal to P2. So pressure in same horizontal line will be same. Suppose there is a liquid, I will draw a line. So each every point pressure will be same, each every point pressure will be same in the horizontal line. But vertically you know, here it is less pressure, here it is more, if we will up down vertically. But horizontally every point pressure is same. I think you understand student this lecture. Just if little bit hurriedly I have told in a faster, then just you slow the video and watch it again and again. I think your all confusion will be clear. We will shortly meet in the next video.